Hey, this is Rozz. This is a show about making undateable guys dateable. You can call this a dating bootcamp where we train guys in the fine art of dating by experts so that they can find true love. Our first candidate is Darryl.
Hi, I'm Darryl. I'm 33 years old, work in private education. I'm currently single and I've been this way all my life.
Okay, so my mission is to help you find a potential girlfriend. But to do that, I need to get to know you first.
Okay.
What kind of girls are you into?
Well, I like her to have a nice sense of humor. Mm-hmm. Has to be decent looking as well. Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, look at me. I look like this and I don't want our kids to, well, you know, have it hard throughout their lives.
Oh no! Which areas do you think you can improve on?
My size, for sure.
Okay.
I'm not as sociable as I like to be. Mm-hmm. Like, if I was at a party, I wouldn't go and talk to some random person.
Oh my god, he sounds like my dream guy. Don't laugh, nobody did you, I did you.
Okay.
Yes. So you say the girls that you liked didn't like you back. Why do you think so?
The biggest piece of advice that they gave me was because I was too boring. I'm someone who likes to go home after work. I don't really go out that much.
Okay.
They want a little bit more adventure in their life, and that's something that they feel that I'm not someone who can provide it to them.
How far are you willing to go on this show to reach your goal?
There isn't much that I wouldn't be willing to do.
I like this challenge. Game on.
People tend to just treat him as a friend rather than wanting to get into a relationship with him. If he focuses on a particular girl, he'll go out of his way to do things for them. They will see it as, you know, he's easily ready for them whenever they need him. But if they don't need him, then they'll just push him to the side. Yeah.
So Darryl, I set you up on a blind date. This is so that I can assess where you need help at, so that I can help you better achieve your goals.
Ooh,
okay? But first, we need to decide on what to wear. So I've made a reservation at this restaurant called Wild Rocket. Great ambiance for like a first date. Dress code is smart cash.
All right.
So let's just look at what do you usually wear. This is a nice color. Can we just throw this shirt out forever and ever? Like, ever.
I can't remember when I last wore that shirt.
Yeah, exactly. This is why it needs to go. I don't even know what stain this is. This is super dodgy. I don't want to ask. Like, hey, let's put it aside because you're not wearing this ever again. Goodbye. Bye. Leave. Is red a bit too much for like a first date?
Well, it was just National Day.
Okay. Actually, this is kind of cool.
This might be a bit tight.
I think it could work. Okay, so it's between this one or the red one. Okay, we're gonna try it with dark blue jeans. Let's give it a shot.
All right.
All right. Hello, Darryl has arrived. Okay, so this shirt fits. That's half the battle won. What about the red shirt?
Red shirt was a little bit too tight. Plus, this is my favorite shirt.
Okay, so now what I feel is it looks a bit sloppy because your jeans are very baggy and straight cut as well. You just tuck it in and see how, let's see how it looks. Okay, nice. You got a nice brown belt, so that adds a pop of color.
Yep.
So let's try to see what it looks like when it's rolled up. Just like roll it twice and then push it up. Are you comfortable with this look?
Yep. These are my shoes.
This one is a definite no. I kind of like this one because it's got a little bit of like a color theme that matches your shirt, and it's kind of casual as well. It's like moccasins. So I say go with this.
Okay.
The jeans here are a bit too long, if I may. This would be like the perfect length. But it's okay for today. Let's just like do this temporary fold in. Do you have like a watch that you can accessorize with?
Yes, I do.
This is a really nice watch. It adds a bit of metallic sheen to your look. So how are you feeling about this look?
Yeah, this is in my wardrobe, but this is a bit of a new look for me.
Okay, I like that. I think we're ready for the first date.
Oh, sounds good.
So this is Melissa. She's gonna be helping me evaluate Darryl by pretending to be his date. I hope he doesn't fall for you because this girl already has a boyfriend. So let's keep it professional. Okay, so before we go on to meet Darryl, I'd like to know your dating experience. When do you start dating?
So I started dating when I was about 15 years old.
Oh, yeah, me too.
I have been on a couple of dates, a good amount for sure.
Have you ever been in love?
Oh sure, many times actually.
Okay, you sound like you have a lot of experience. How old are you this year?
I'm actually in my late 20s.
Perfect age for Darryl. Okay, so anyway, before we meet Darryl, I've got this little thing for you. It's a little hidden earpiece. Okay, I'm gonna be throwing Darryl some curveballs throughout the date, and you are gonna be receiving instructions from me through this earpiece. I'll be watching you guys through the screen right here.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Hey, this is Melissa.
Hey, hi.
Hi, Melissa.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Hi.
Enjoy your date, get to know each other, and I'll come back after.
Cool.
Have fun.
Thank you. Oh, how's your day?
Yeah, it's been great.
Good. Managed to find your way here all right?
Yeah, it was okay. I took a taxi here just now.
It's like a bad Channel 5 drama. So awkward.
First time here?
Yeah, kind of, yes.
Kind of, yeah, same for me as well.
Okay.
I heard the food here is supposed to be pretty good.
Yeah, I heard that too, actually.
Okay,
we can test it out later.
Yeah, sure.
Melissa, tell him that you're feeling cold. Ask him if he's cold.
Actually, the air conditioning is a bit cold. Do you feel cold?
I feel all right. We'll probably get him to turn it up a bit.
He's so considerate, such a sweet guy.
Sorry. I'll wait till she comes back first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ask him how many girlfriends he's got before.
How many girlfriends have you had before?
None.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I see.
So, I haven't been in a relationship pretty much, at all. Yourself?
I've been about 2 relationships before. I'm still feeling pretty cold.
Yeah.
Is it me or is it, I don't know?
I'm not too sure. I'll probably check with them.
I think he's also quite reluctant to get the aircon to be turned up because he's sweating profusely right now.
She's feeling a little bit chilly. Can you turn up the temperature a little bit?
Yeah. Thank you.
How do you relieve your stress?
I go to the gym.
Okay.
So I'm quite a gym junkie in that sense.
He doesn't like exercising, clearly.
Do you want to work out with me sometime?
Oh, wait. With you? Maybe. I'll think about it.
Lies.
Yes, thank you.
This will be the pomelo salad.
Okay, take a lot of food photos, okay? And try to take photos of his food as well. Ask him, don't eat. Let me take photo first.
Hold on. Can I just take
sure.
a few? Yeah, you know, food pornography.
It's a girl thing to do, don't worry.
It's a girl thing to do. Move his bowl around, just be irritating.
Can you help me with this? Can you just tilt a bit? Ah, okay. Okay.
Ask him to like hide his thumbs. Can see his thumbs.
Hide your thumb a bit. Okay.
Which one, left or right?
The left one.
Ask him to tilt the bowl a little bit. Help you with the photo.
No. This is floating. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. Great.
Doesn't look the least bit annoyed.
If you're interested, I'll send you a picture later.
Sure.
Okay. How is it?
It's not bad, it's quite nice. It's quite really tasty. Okay. Would you like to try some?
Okay, sure. Thank you. You want to try this ice cream thing?
No, I'm not really a big fan of coconut.
No, you take a bite and then you tell him it's really good. Ask him once again, are you sure you don't want to try?
The coconut is really nice. You want to try some, you'll regret it.
If I don't. Okay, yeah.
I cannot believe he's actually trying. Oh, he's a sweet guy.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. No, I regretted it when you tried.
Get your lipstick smudged and see if he notices.
We had this group of primary school friends come down.
Okay.
They had a wedding here.
He doesn't notice the smudge. The smudge is there, but it's not very obvious. Can you smudge the other side?
Usually, what do you get up to on weekends?
About 10. 10-ish.
Oh.
I try to sleep in as much as possible.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh. Want to wipe a little bit?
Yeah, I look like a clown, is it?
No lah, not that bad lah.
Lucky you told me, or not, I would have walked out looking like I don't know.
Oh, don't worry, I've walked out in worse conditions before.
Really? Like?
But I think there was this one time. I went to get my teeth done. They inject anesthetic so you can't feel anything. There's somebody sitting next to me. They're smiling at the person. The person looked at me grossed out. It's like, I was wondering why. Then when I looked down, I realized all my saliva had dripped down with all the blood all over my shirt.
Oh, and he tells her a story of him being worse off than her. So thoughtful. Why is he single? I don't understand.
Thanks for the lunch today.
Yeah, no problem. Hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
Hope you enjoyed it as well.
Yeah, I did as well.
Alright, so we're done with the date. Now I'm gonna have a little chat with Melissa to find out how Darryl did. Okay, so how do you think Darryl did on the date?
Darryl is a very nice guy. He is considerate. He's caring. He is attentive.
But is there anything he can improve on?
Probably it would be better if he is a bit more cheeky. Or probably there's some element of surprise to him. I think that would really turn girls on.
Okay, so you didn't feel any sparks because he was so straightforwardly polite.
So I feel comfortable. But the thing is, I just felt like there was something missing. Probably he's not my type.
because I'm a bit of like a gym fanatic, so I would prefer somebody who is like
more fit.
Yeah, more fit. And
he can change his body.
is he really gonna go through like and become a different person at the end of the?
Why are you gonna regret this? You wanna place your bets now? You wanna invest a bit first now? Because I tell you, once the product finish and it's stellar, he got no say already. It's open market really to everybody.
Okay, so now I finally got a good sense of what Darryl needs to achieve his goal. I'll get working on it. This is only episode one. We have a long way to go. I hope you guys like this video. Now here at Clicknetwork, we're testing out a few new shows at the moment, and this is one of them. If you like this video and you'd like to see the rest of Darryl's journey, please give us a thumbs up and leave a comment below. If we get enough good response, we might just continue the show. Will Darryl find love? Will he get into shape? I'm gonna shop for a new wardrobe for him and do all the fun stuff. So we hope to see you in the future. Thanks for watching. This is Rozz. Bye.